Welcome, ServiceNow developers. In this installment of Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform, we're going to quickly turn our attention to a class that's all about the user, GlideUser. The API is indispensable for obtaining information about the current user, and it's used to personalize their experience. The GlideUser API allows us to access details about the logged-in user, so such as their ID, their name, their roles, and a lot more. It's particularly useful for scripts where the context of the user is important. So things like UI policies, client scripts, and access controls. Using the GlideUser API avoids the need to use things like Glide Record, which ends up being slower to get information about your user. As we jump in, notice that not all of our Glide APIs have their own namespace. So date time has Glide date time. Curing records has Glide record. The Glide user namespace is all included in GS. So in a previous lesson, we already touched on some of the Glide user methods that we'll be going over again today, but we're going to explore most of the rest of them now because they honestly come up pretty often. Okay, so let's dive in. You'll see that I've already displayed a lot on the screen, and we're going to go through them so that you kind of understand what we're doing. And before we jump into all of these different methods, notice that I first started with creating a new getUser object. I said, let's create a new variable called user, and I'm going to put all the user information into that new variable by saying gs.getUser. And that's how you start all of these methods off. Make sure you have that, or else these user dot methods down here won't work. This first group of methods is all about like basic user information. So you'll see things like, what is the display name of that person? What's their first name? What's their last name? What's their username instead? And then finally, what's their ID? So their actual unique ID within the instance so that you can make sure that you don't have duplicates. So if we run this, we'll see all of them. The display name, I'm logged in as my default admin account, so system administrator. What's my first name? System. My last name? Administrator. My username is admin. And then my unique ID for my admin account on this instance is this sysid. So now we have a unique sysid, and this is a unique ID across all instances. So I can be confident that if I use that unique ID, that there won't be any collisions. And then let's look at that rest of those user methods. We can see things like, do they have a particular role that I'm looking for? What is their company ID, if there is a company attached to this person? What's their email address? What are all the groups that this person belongs in? What are all the roles that this person has? What are the roles that I've been explicitly assigned to as opposed to inherited via other roles? And then finally, is this person a member of a particular group? So if I run this, you'll see that it pops out all the information that I asked for. Does this person have the ITIL role? I'm admin. Yeah, I do. What's my company ID? This account doesn't belong to a company, so it came out blank. Email address is the default admin at example.com. All the groups that I belong to, I'm only in one group, so it made one and it already put it in an array for me too. Here's all the roles that I have, and it's a lot because I'm an admin, but here are my explicitly assigned roles and not just inherited from other roles, admin and security admin. That's what I would expect. And then is this person in the help desk group? Nope, I'm the admin. It's not in any of those groups. So very useful stuff to know about your user, and now you can write scripts based off of that information. Awesome.